Hello friends, today we'll talk about RS232, RS422 and RS485, the basic features, how it works and example design. We'll design one example to work with it, RS422 communication. So let's start it. The RS232, RS422 and RS485 designations refer to interfaces for digital data transmission. The RS232 standard is better known as a normal computer COM port or serial port, although Ethernet, firmware, and USB can also be considered as a serial port. The RS422 and RS485 interfaces are widely used in the industry for connecting various equipment. The table shows the main difference between the RS232, RS422, and RS485 interfaces. So here we see the port name is RS232, RS422 and RS485. Transfer type, there is full duplex. RS422 also full duplex, and RS485 half duplex and full duplex mode. If we use two wires, then it will act as a half duplex, and four wires full duplex mode. Maximum distance we can work with is 15 meters at 960 bps, where we can go up to 200 kbps. In RS422, 1200 meters at 960 baud rate and 1200 meters at 960 baud rate. Contacts in use, TXT, RXD, that is transmitter data transmit, receive data transmit, RTS, CDS, TTR, DSR, DCT and ground. In case of RS422, TXA, TXB, that is transmitter A, transmitter B port, receiver A, receiver B port and ground. And in case of RS485, it is data A, data B and ground. Topology used in RS232 is point to point and RS422 is point to point, but in case of RS485, it is multipoint. So maximum number of connected devices, RS232 1. And in RS422, it is 10 devices in receive mode as a slave and 32 with repeaters larger. So, what is the differences between RS232, RS422 and RS485? RS232 is full duplex. As we said, RS485 is half duplex and RS422 is full duplex. RS485 and RS232 are only the physical protocol for communication, i.e. interface standard. RS485 is the differential transmission mode. RS232 is the single ended transmission mode, but the communication program does not have much difference. The PC is already equipped with RS232, as we see COM port, which can be used directly. If RS-485 communication is used, it is only the necessary to connect an RS-232 to RS-485 conversion head on the RS-232 port, and there is no need to modify the program. So here are the COM ports. RS-232 connected DB9 connector used in COM PC. RS-422 here TXT minus RXT plus ground, TXT plus RXT minus. RS-485 is GANP. Okay, now RS-232 overview we'll see. RS-232 interface complies with the interfaces standard serial data communication established by the Electronic Industry Alliance, this is EIA. The original number is EIA RS-232 for short. It is widely used for computer serial interface peripheral connections, connect cables and mechanical, electrical signal and transfer processes. The data transmission rate specified by RS-232 standard is 50, 75, 100, 50, 300, 600 and up to 1920 baud rate per second. So here is the RS-232 pinout. Here we can see DB9 port. The RS-232 interface TIA-EIA RS-232 is intended for the organization of data transfer between the transmitter terminal, data terminal equipment DTE, and the receiver or communication equipment, data communications equipment DCE, in the point-to-point scheme. The speed of RS232 depends on the distance between the devices. Usually, at a distance of 15 meters, the speed is 9600 bps. At a minimum distance, the speed is usually 115.2 kbps, but there is hardware that supports the speeds of up to 921.6 kbps. So we'll see the information on the RS232 interface is transmitted digitally by logical 0 and 1, and this the logical warm mark, this logical warm mark corresponds to a voltage in the range from -3 to -15 volt, and the logical 0 space corresponds to voltage range from +3 to +15 volt. The two work with RS232 devices, we usually need only three contacts, that is RSD, DXD and ground, but some devices require all nine contacts to support the flow control function. One message sent over RS232, RS485 consists of start bit, several data bits, parity bit and stop bit. The start bit is the bit denoting the beginning of the transmission, usually 0. Data bits 5, 6, 7 or 8 can be. The first bit is the less significant bit. Parity bit, a bit intended for parity checking. It serves for detecting errors. The parity event takes such a value that the number of units in the message is even. Oddness takes one such value that the number of units in the message is odd. And stop bit, a bit indicating the completion of the message transmission. The structure of transmitted data in RS232 is like that. What I have described, data line, start bit, data word and stop bit, and has the paired bit. Now, these are the RS232 features. Here we are using this transmitter B plus, transmitter A minus, and receiver B plus, receiver A minus. So here it will be connecting to transmitter A minus, will be connected to receiver A minus. Transmitter B minus will be connected to receiver B minus, B plus. Receiver B plus will be connected to transmitter B plus, and transmitter A minus will be connected to receiver A minus. So RS422 interface is similar to RS232, allows you to simultaneously send and receive messages on separate lines, full duplex, but uses a differential signal line for these, i.e. the potential difference between conductors A and B. The data transfer between speed is RS422 depends on the distance and can vary from 10 kbps 1200 meters to 10 mbps 10 meters. In the RS422 network, there can only be one transmitting device and up to 10 receiving devices. The RS422 line is 4 wires for data transmission, 2 twisted wires for transmission, 2 twisted wires for receiving, and 1 common ground. Here it depicts twisted wires with each other allows you to get rid of interference. Now we'll see why we are using this, why it is better than RS232, and why it is differential. Twisting wire with each other allows you to get rid of interference, and interference because of the interference acts equally on both wires, and information is extracted from the potential difference between the conductor A and conductor B of the line. The voltage on the data lines can be in the range from -6 to +6 volt. The logical difference between A and B is greater than 0.2 volt, that is 200 millivolt. Logical 1 corresponds to the difference between A and B lines less than -0.2 volt. The RS422 standard does not define a specific type of connector. Usually it can be a terminal block or a dividend connector. RS422 pinout depends on the manufacturer of the device and is specified in the documentation for it. Now let's see RS485 connector. RS422 overview. The full name of the RS422 standard is Electrical Characteristics of the Balanced Voltage Digital Interface Circuit, which defines the characteristics of the interface circuit. There is a signal ground, a total of 5 lines. Since the receiver uses high input impedance and transmission driver has more vital driving capability than RS232, it can connect multiple receiving modes on the same transmission line, and up to 10 nodes can be connected. one master device and the slave devices. The slave device cannot communicate with each other. So RS422 supports 0.2 multidirectional two-way communication. The receiver input impedance is 4k, so the maximum load capacity of the transmitter is 10 and times 4k plus 100. RS422 also can work and is safe with full duplex operation through two pairs of two set pairs. RS485 will work in half duplex and cannot perform transmission reception simultaneously, but it only needs one couple of two set pairs. RS422 and RS485 can transmit 1200 meters at 19 kbps. A device can connect to the line on the new transceiver. Now let's see RS485 overview. The RS485 serial bus is widely used when the communication distance must be several tens of meters to several kilometers. RS485 uses balanced transmit and differential receives so that it can reject common mode interference. In addition to the high sensitivity of the bus transceiver, it can detect voltages as low as 200 millivolt, so recover the transmitter signal beyond the kilometer. RS485 uses a half duplex mode of operation and sends only one point at a time. Therefore, the transmitting circuit must be controlled by an enable signal. So, this is the master. This is slave 1, slave 2, etc. One twisted pair signal is used and one ground is declared. So, let's see on RS485 features. RS485 is very convenient for multipoint interconnection and can save many signal lines. Applications for RS485 can be networked to form a distributed system that allows up to 32 drives and 32 receivers connected in parallel. In response to the shortcoming of RS232C, the new standard RS485 has the following features. Electrical characteristics of RS485. The logic 1 is represented by the voltage difference between the two lines plus 2 to plus 6 volt, and logic 0 is represented by voltage difference between two lines minus 6 to minus 2 volt. The interference signal level is lower than RS232C as we see, and it is not easy to damage the interference circuit chip. The level is compatible with the TTL level, which is convenient for connecting with the TTL circuit. The highest data rate in this is 10 Mbps. That's all. Now we'll see the main differences between RS232, RS422 and RS485. Now this is a table comprising the differences between these three terminology. Mode of operation: in RS232 there is single ended. In RS422 it is differential, and it is also differential in terms of RS485. Total number of drivers and receivers on one line: one driver and one receiver in RS232. In RS422 it is one driver and 10 receiver. In RS485 it is one driver and 32 receivers. Maximum cable length, it can be used 50 feet, 4000 feet in case of RS422 and 4000 feet also in case of RS485. Maximum data rate, it is 460 kbps. In case of RS422 it is 10 mbps. RS485 it is also 30 mbps. Maximum driver output voltage, it can give plus minus 25 volt. In RS422 it gives minus 0.25 volt to plus 6 volt, and in case of RS485 it is minus 4 volt 7 volt to plus 12 volt. So these are the maximum parameters, main difference between this three serial communication: RS232, RS482, 422 and RS485. So that is the difference. Now we'll design one example to show how it communicates. Let's see. Now we'll go to example design.